Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update.
First of all, congratulations to all three of you for being winners of the Film Companion Film Club 2020 Awards. Yay!
This is exciting. I can't believe. You see some of the nominees that I had. I don't know what you all. Ranveer Singh. Like, he should beat me 40, 50 times over any other, like.
Well, you know, yeah. I'll tell you, this is a very special online community. Yeah, there's about 17,000. No, no. It's 17,000 people online.
Wow.
And yeah, you're trying not to touch your face. Well done. And the voting nominees and winners is completely done by the members of the Film Companion Film Club.
Yeah.
We got like 400 to 500 votes per day.
Wow.
For each category. So this is a very passionate, very active community. I'm going to read out all the winners and then I'm going to start asking you
I also have
questions.
A lot of my fan base who are in IT.
Huh.
And they definitely cheated.
You just basically, you rigged it,
I admitted I cheated.
EVM pe dal.
There are ways to cheat. There are bots and all that.
So here are the winners. Okay, best newcomer, Gitika Vidya, Sony. Nice. Best editing, Prerna Sehgal, Mard Ko Dard Nahi Hota.
Bravo.
Best cinematographer, Ewan Mulligan, Article 15.
Bravo.
Best screenplay, Anubhav Sinha, Gaurav Solanki, Article 15.
Bravo.
Best song, Divine Dub Sharma, Azadi, Gully Boy.
Yes.
Best non-Hindi film, Super Deluxe. Best director, Abhishek Chaubey, Son Chiriya. Best performance male, Gulshan Devaiah, Mard Ko Dard Nahi Hota.
Bravo.
Best performance female, Gitika Vidya, again for Sony.
Bravo.
And best film, Son Chiriya.
Wow.
Isn't that great?
Yes, it's excellent and rather unexpected too.
Yeah, it is.
So I'm going to ask you all the same questions. These are just about your process and how you all work. And I'd like each one of you to answer this. So Gaurav, let's start with you. Is there a specific moment that made you fall in love with what you do?
I don't remember it. There must be a lot of those moments, a lot of films which made me fall in love with my work or writing.
But koi ek stand out nahi karti.
Rang De Basanti moved me a lot when I was in college. So it was a different kind of commercial mainstream film. So mujhe laga ki Vishal Bhardwaj ki film hone bahut mujhe Makbool aur Omkara ne bahut move kiya. So
Abhishek, for you?
I mean, from a very young age, I was in love with the movies. But the first few years when I came to Bombay, it was all a struggle because you were an intern in AD and it's a difficult life back then. But when I read the script of Makbool and I knew I wanted to be a part of it, it was when I realized that this is a good way to go. This is a good job.
I'm an only child. I lived in the world of fantasy, so movies were definitely an influence. And I have romanticized and over-romanticized the whole idea of cinema and all that. And funnily, I never used to go to the movie halls and watch movies. I used to watch it on television or VHS. But I do remember like the time, I think one of the most profound impacts that I had watching while watching a film on cinema was Schindler's List. I was 16 maybe. And then it's just really something that I didn't expect. And I actually saw the ad on paper and I asked a few friends and I had very few people who wanted to see this because most of them wanted to watch a Stallone movie or a Jackie Chan movie or a, you know, Schwarzenegger
movie. Big action
movie.
Ones,
yeah. But those were the ones that used to release like in the in the mid-90s in English cinema halls in Bangalore. So I think I lived in the world of fantasy, but then I think it just, I always wanted to be an actor. I can't remember that one point, but I remember fantasizing myself being on movie posters, on billboards. And there's a film called Yaadon Ki Baraat, which has Dharmender.
Of course.
In like his denim jacket and he's like that. So I used to just try and do that. I still can't do it. But that really captured my imagination. And Shashi Kapoor, like I used to really like Shashi Kapoor. I didn't want to be like them, but then being an only child and living in your fantasy and then just making up stories in your own head. So it was, I chose my destiny, I suppose.
Okay, with the second one, you go first. What's the most useful piece of practical advice you've got in your career?
While shooting for Mard Ko Dard Nahi Hota on my first day of action, and we had been preparing for nearly 4 months, I had been training and then Eric Jacobus had come and we were shooting the first scene, which is the office fight sequence. This is a lot, no? Office fight sequence. So, and I was really like focused, and I was isolating myself, and I was doing my exercises, and my knee had gone through an operation, so it wasn't really in best shape. So I was stretching and limbering up and all that. So I gave my first few shots, and he was really happy. He was really thrilled because I think all that work and was really came good. And then I was like, and he seemed genuinely happy. So he ran up to me and he hugged me and all that. And during lunch break, we were chatting, and then I told him like, you know, I really want to do better. Like this, I have a good feeling. I want to do better. So he said like, you're doing good, right? Just stay there. Like, don't try to like really be in a hurry to get better. You're doing really well. Just stay there. And I was like, that was the best advice anybody has given me on a film set. It made total sense to me to just relax and enjoy that moment and just be there. And then you enjoy the process, it will get better. You don't have to really try to get better.
You sure, will. Don't strain.
Yeah, yeah. So thank you, Eric. Thanks.
Abhishek, for you.
Well, I mean, this might sound obvious when I say it, but it wasn't so obvious when I was working, when I heard it back then. A couple of things, really. One was, when I was still in ADN, I had the ambition of becoming a director, and I really thought that becoming a director is about staging a scene, visualizing it and all of that, and I was really thinking about all of those things. I really wasn't thinking about writing a script, and just to be told that beta agar director banna hai to likho pehle, you know, it was as simple as that. And Vishal said that to me, and after Maqbool I wrote my first script, and you know, and so that's really when my directorial journey really began in the real sense. That was one. And the other thing that happened with Naseer Bhai, while I was making my first film, and I'm already a director now and I'm supposed to know my job, and but I'm still in that phase where I'm trying to explain to him the larger context of this scene and what it means to, you know, in the theory of the film and all of that. And he just said, beta, that's all right, but what am I supposed to do here? And that's, I mean, you know, you learn to understand things simply and just explain to them, just do this.
Right.
We'll deal with the, you know, meta later.
वो हमेशा अभी मैं भी रिसेंटली उनके साथ काम कर रहा था एक फिल्म के लिए तो उन्होंने बोला मेरे साथ मुझे साइको एनालिसिस नहीं करना है कैरेक्टर का मुझे बस लाइफ बता दो उसकी आई डोंट वांट टू ओवरथिंक अबाउट इट
राइट राइट व्हाट अबाउट यू इज देयर एनी अदर पीस ऑफ एडवाइस
सो वन व्हिच आई स्ट्रांगली रिमेंबर व्हिच आई टोल्ड यू इन माय इंटरव्यू विद यू कि हमेशा हथियार अपने तराशते रहो और क्योंकि जब तक आपका काम बाहर नहीं आता तब तक वेट कर रहे हो तो आप अपना काम और इम्प्रूव करते रहो और एक बार जब आप ज़्यादा काम करने लगते हो तब आपके पास हथियार तैयार करने का टाइम नहीं मिलता जब वॉर शुरू हो जाती है सो बी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर दैट एंड यूज़ द टाइम एक और एडवाइस जो बहुत चलते चलते ऐसे ही आई वॉज राइटिंग सॉन्ग्स फॉर अगली विद अनुराग कश्यप फिल्म तो अनुराग ने मुझे एक दिन ऐसे ही बोला बॉम्बे वेलवेट का कुछ प्री प्रोडक्शन चल रहा था ही सेड कि इट्स गुड दैट बॉम्बे वेलवेट इज़ नॉट योर फर्स्ट फिल्म इट्स अ स्मॉल फिल्म इट्स कि तुम बहुत बड़े बड़े गाने नहीं लिख रहे हो बहुत बड़ा वो नहीं कर रहे हो इट्स गुड कि तुम धीरे धीरे करो उस वक्त मुझे समझ उतना नहीं आया पर अभी लगता है कि वो धीरे धीरे होने से क्या होता है आपका काम पे आप बहुत काम करते हो अगर आपको बहुत जल्दी सक्सेस मिल जाती है या कोई बहुत बड़े काम से जल्दी जुड़ जाते हो तो शायद आपको लगता है हो तो गया अब और क्यों मेहनत कर रहे हो
ऑल्सो इज लाइक व्हाट ही इज सेइंग इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड आई हैव नोटिस दैट लाइक इन अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल दैट आई थिंक अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल कांट रियली हैंडल इट ऑल्सो इट्स नॉट ओनली द क्राफ्ट बट इट्स द लाइफ आफ्टर लाइक बिकॉज सो मेनी यू गेट सो मच अटेंशन ऑन यू And you have so many people saying so many nice things and treating you well and then...
Yeah, you become special suddenly.
And many people can't handle it.
Yeah. Handling success is far more difficult than failure.
Yeah, far more
so it's like, I remember like my first years over here and when I was in award ceremonies and I'm sitting like three seats away from Madhuri Dixit. No, I won't die. So I couldn't handle it. And I remember asking, like, you know, like quietly praying, saying that, listen, I'm really happy, like God, universe, or whatever, like this mysterious energy that's making things happening for me. But like, don't give me things like, quickly because I clearly can't handle it. Yeah, but now I'm okay.
Yeah, it's not much time, much like
I'll be grounded. Best actor.
Okay. Abhishek, let's start with you on this one. What's the one part of your job that you dislike?
Oh, well, the marketing campaign that precedes the release of a film.
What are you saying?
Painful. It's painful. I mean, it's all about appearances. I mean, you know, the good thing about my job is that the good thing about being in films is that we don't have a dress code. You can just be, you know, be whatever you like, and just
well, directors get to be whatever.
Especially
they like.
Directors, yeah, yes, yeah. Especially directors, and I kind of like that freedom, and you know, but when it comes to the marketing, I mean, you've got to make, you know, you've got to give so many interviews, and you've got to, it's all about appearances, and you've got to even sometimes say things that you don't really believe that much.
Sure.
so that is, I find it very painful, because rest of it is filmmaking, and that's great. I
mean, any producers who are going to watch this do this. La 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 la.
Gulshan, what do you hate about your job?
Nothing really.
But just one part. One part that you like less than the others.
That you have to hustle. I mean, I do enjoy it. But then the fact that you have to hustle also, because just being good is not good enough. And there's a certain idealism that I think I grew up with. Mm-hmm. And a lot of aspiring actors, they have that. Who are associated with any sort of arts. There's a certain idealism which keeps us going also. But also you have to like find the right balance between that and pragmatism. So I always believe that, you know, you just have to be good, really good, and that's good enough. And there's always a moment of rude awakening when you learn that that's not true for either of us.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
And there's a certain hustle, which can be fun also, but it can be really exhausting also, because you feel that you have to do, why do I have to do it? Why can't just being good be good enough?
Yeah, that's a tough one. Yeah. Gaurav?
Mujhe lagta hai ki jab hum kuch likh rahe hote hain, toh we spend a lot of time with that content. So, dialogue se leke, client se leke, her scene ke, 50 option aap sochte ho, then you choose one. And then the script goes out to a director and actor, sorry. Aur kahi baar sab log bhool jate hain, कि जो ऑप्शंस हम डिस्कस कर रहे हैं वो पहले ही रिजेक्ट हो चुके हैं देन यू हैव टू गो ऑन दैट जर्नी विद एवरीवन विद एक्टर्स एंड विद डायरेक्टर और वो घूम फिर के अक्सर वहीं आती है बात कि नहीं ये इसलिए नहीं वर्क करेगा ये इसलिए नहीं वर्क करेगा सो दैट्स पार्ट ऑफ द प्रोसेस बट वो कभी कभी फ्रस्ट्रेटिंग हो जाता है
यस आई कैन इमेजिन ओके व्हाट आर यू ऑल लाइक द नाइट बिफोर रिलीज गुलशन
Now I just sleep quite peacefully.
Achha.
I do.
But pehle
I'm experienced now. I'm a veteran.
Manje hue khiladi.
Manje hue khiladi. Pehle to julap.
Three, 4 days. Uske beech mein kuch nahi tha.
There is nothing. There's just severe diarrhea. Severe.
Abhishek.
Mostly I'm drunk. before release, yeah. Mostly yes. I'm also not very jittery or nervous before release anymore, and I'm also not that kind of director who goes to the theater to see the audience reactions. And all I don't do that anymore.
Yeah,
it is that my first film, and I realize it's not important. To do that. So I'm pretty chill, and I'm very happy that the film is over. So I just celebrate.
My only experience is Article 15, and thankfully. ट्रेलर का बहुत अच्छा रिस्पॉन्स आया था सो आई वॉज अ बिट कॉन्फिडेंट आई वॉज अ लिटल बिट नर्वस बिफोर द ट्रेलर केम आउट सो कुछ नॉर्मल था
ओके व्हाट्स द वन थिंग गौरव दैट यू शुड नेवर से टू अ राइटर
इंटरेस्टिंग
एक लाइन सुना के कभी ये मत बोलो कि दिस इज अ स्टोरी
राइट
I have a story idea and that's only a one-liner.
और फिर यही कहानी है।
फिर यही कहानी है। कई बार तो लोग क्रेडिट मांगने लगते हैं उसपे। कि ये देखो कहानी तो मेरी है।
करेक्ट। उसके बाद तो मेरा
है। हाँ, तो स्टोरी ये था। स्क्रीन प्ले तुम्हारा है।
करेक्ट। अभिषेक, what should one never tell a director?
Well, mostly on a set or on a film, most people are telling things to directors that you should not be telling them. I mean,
What's the one thing that's your pet peeve?
See, the thing is, if you're not able to do what you want, I mean, as a director, I like to believe I'm pretty accommodating. However, every time you're on set, mostly you're being told what you cannot do. Several things you're okay with, but if you can't, if it's going to be a problem regarding the acting or the image, then I just can't take it. I mean, we'll shoot it some other day. So these two things are very critical to me, you know. So, yeah, date nahi hai. You know, for example,
Gulshan sun rahe ho na, dhyan se.
And also another thing that I like to shoot on real locations, and I recce the hell out of places. And somebody tells me you can't shoot there. You know, that just gets to me. Ye post mein kar lenge actually. That's the worst. Ye VFX mein kar lenge.
Sambhal lenge post
mein. That doesn't work.
Yeah. Actor ke liye.
One more for sound, one more for focus. I never want to hear that. Because sometimes you're really flowing. You know? You're really flowing. You only have that many great takes. Like, you'll have good takes, but the great ones, like sometimes everything is just right, the environment is conducive, and you give a great take, and then you're like, one more for sound, and that's like without any emotion. Like, you know, just like they don't care. Like, one more for sound, one more for focus. Focus people are a little careful because they would have seen the actor, they're like, sound people are sitting somewhere else, like, one more for sound, and they were like, oh.
Hamare set pe to ek bar ye bhi hua tha, bahut lamba take tha, uske baad sabko acha laga, and then wo somebody said ki sir role hi nahi hua tha.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Oh, then everybody was clueless and annoyed.
These are things that actors don't like to hear. I kind of
sorry guys, do we have a problem? Who's?
Yes,
Kiska?
It's
one. What did I say?
Sir, one more for sound.
Yeah, one more for sound. I hate that when people say like one more for sound, one more for focus. Like actors don't like hearing this because sometimes you're really flowing, you know, you have a great take and you have only that many great takes, and you have really good takes, you can have a lot of good takes, but those great ones are really rare to come by because the whole environment is conducive. See how I remember all my lines.
I love it. I love it. Take two is very good.
Take two, yeah. So it's, and then you hear like, and they're very dispassionate about it, the sound wallahs. Because they're sitting somewhere, they're not really watching your take, they're just listening and like, one more for sound after cut. And you're like, oh man, that was so good. Why do we have to do it? And particularly a lot of people shoot sync sound. I mean, that's the way to go. You should always shoot sync sound, but they are the bane in our lives.
Okay, what's the last work that you saw? What's the last piece of writing or that you saw that made you envious?
The series, The Affair.
Nahi.
Hindi?
Hamar.
Hamara.
Hamar. Indian cinema. Chalo, we won't keep it to
Talwar. Hindi. Talwar.
Talwar. Hmm. Wo to kaafi saal ho gaye, Gaurav.
But I was deeply moved by it, and it was a very difficult screenplay to write. Yeah. I think it's Vishal Bhardwaj ka best screenplay. Mere hisab se.
Mujhe bhi aisa. Aisa. Sahi baat hai.
Bahut mushkil tha usko likhna. It's usme jo journalistic quality hai aur jo sub sides ko characters ko saath saath explore karna, it's very beautiful.
Abhishek?
Jallikattu that I saw last year.
Fabulous.
Yeah, it's one of the best films I saw last year. And generally, Lijo, his career, the kind of films he's made, it's very, for somebody like me, it's very inspirational. I mean, I really enjoy his work.
Yeah.
So his work, yeah.
Andhadum. So jealous.
I too love Andhadum.
Yeah, it's a great, and like, Sriram sir, of course, he's a legend. And his scripts are so great, his characters that he writes are so great. That part of Raghu's, or like, was it Raghu? No, Raghu was in, again, both his movies, Badlapur also.
Badlapur also, fabulous.
Yeah, so two movies of his back to back, I was like, I was looking at the leading man, I was like, man, what would I have given? Like, I would have readily embraced coronavirus just to do that part. Yeah, it's a great. I really enjoyed it. And I've told those guys also that I'm so envious. You never keep it inside. You should always let it out.
Correct. Okay, what's the strangest criticism you've ever got, Abhishek?
Most criticism that's not in your favor is strange.
It's all strange.
Yeah, I mean, you know, things like that you hear, I mean, you know, that aap to Hindi mein film hi nahi banate. So that kind of a thing. Because,
oh, you get told that.
Yeah, I get told that because And somewhere I wear it in my sleeve. I mean, I'm happy about that.
I
don't mind that. In the sense that you use dialect, so in fact, I was told in Urta Punjab ki, by someone in a position of authority that I don't think I'm going to give you a Hindi film. I'll call it a Punjabi film and you'll have to release it that way. Distribution issues. Yeah, cool man.
It's a compliment, you know.
Gaurav.
One close friend didn't like Article 15 and he said there is too much of you in this film.
Yes. And
he knows me personally, so he said there is the way characters are speaking, things they are saying, there is too much of you in this. It should be lesser than that.
Whoa. Wow.
So
That's worth thinking about. Yeah.
I don't get criticized at
all. I'm perfect.
I'm just the boss of the cosmos. I don't remember that kind of criticism, as in like apart from flop actor and things like that. But those are like troll sort of level.
Huh.
I did a film a couple of years ago called Kuldeep Patwal. I didn't do it, but I play a Punjabi lawyer. And I speak in Punjabi in that, and I had a really big false moustache, really false-looking false moustache. So, I mean, regardless of what I think of the film and what people thought of the film, then when it released, one of the reviews, it was an online portal. The reviewer had mentioned, like, I don't know why actors like Deepak Dobriyal and Gulshan did this. I mean, they must have just done it for the money or something. It's not really a criticism, it's his interpretation.
Sure.
So, and I kind of took some slight offense to it. So I kind of tracked him down and privately I didn't want to make like a tamasha online just in case, because it's also important to understand the context. And also that person has very good regards for me, which is why they feel that I shouldn't be doing movies such as this. So then I sent him a message saying that, private message saying that, listen, like I didn't do this for the money at all. But when I was doing this, it seemed like a great idea. But many times we do things because it seems like it's a good idea, but
sure.
It doesn't have to
seems
work out that way.
Seems better on paper
than it because
is.
There's only that much that you can control. You can't control how the film will turn out, the director's vision, how the other actors, you can't control how the distribution, you can't really control all of these factors. And hence the movie turned out the way it did, which you didn't clearly like. But then it's not that, you know, I live in a rented house, I'm doing my own car. If I was doing things for money, you'd be seeing me in a lot more films and I'd like be like, you know, have all those things. So I don't do this for money. He actually agreed with me and he re-edited the
movie. Really?
Yeah, yeah. So that was really sweet.
That's sweet, yeah.
Nice. Okay, guys, last question. We'll start, Gaurav, with you. What is the one thing you want to change about the film industry?
That's a difficult one. So, I think I want all of us to make more stories which are rooted in Indian lives, in small towns of India or cities of India, but which are not inspired from some Western work or some Korean film or something else. So, zyada, because we have a lot of stories, hum sab ki bahut kahaniyan hai. So, वो ज़्यादा बने जो थोड़ा बदल रहा है पर और ज़्यादा बदले तो
can I just add to that?
Yeah.
Also outside the Hindi belt.
Right.
Right.
Because India is very
massive.
Vast.
Yeah.
You can make a Hindi film that is based in
और हमारे सामने problem होती है कि हम राजस्थान की कहानी बना रहे हैं पर हमको हिंदी में बनानी है क्योंकि वो 10-11 states देखेंगे उसको हमको लगता है. So हम वो जैसे ये तो अपनी फिल्मों में dialect काफी use करते हैं but वो बहुत कम हो रहा है. And authenticity, I think, compromise hoti hai thoda usse. And that's a...
I think it's a great... I mean,
that's a weird problem.
Study your discussions while this
because,
talk.
Yeah, you want to reach out to more
absolutely.
Audience. That's also a challenge.
It's a tough call.
It's
no?
a tough call.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you have to
call.
Weigh
yeah,
all
yeah,
of it
right,
together.
Right.
But it's possible.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
But you want more desi stories.
More, yeah. Not necessarily small town stories, but Bombay ki story bhi bane, par hamari stories ho.
Correct.
New York ki story ka Bombay version.
Version nahi.
Haan.
Abhishek.
Oh well, I mean, it might sound too idealistic, but I think I think our obsession with commercial success or rather the fear of commercial failure is something, you know, that we ought to change about ourselves, because I'm quite certain that even if we lose that fear, the hit-flop ratio is not going to change.
Right, right.
And it's going to free us up to be able to produce more varied kind of content, which is what we need to do.
Yeah.
That's very important.
Same lines. The whole, I think the person who, the genius who came up with the whole idea to use box office figures as a PR stunt must be kicking himself.
But yeah, up to 300
I'm
crore
pretty sure it's a he.
You know?
I'm pretty sure it's a he, because this kind of dumb idea is only men. Yeah.
Come from men, yes. Mine is bigger than yours. It's basically
that. Is that.
Fundamentally, that's what it is.
It completely takes away the... And like, when they are like... I was speaking to somebody who was a jury member in an award ceremony, and then they were saying, "Arey, nahi to wo picture to chali nahi thi." Isliye wo
usko consider bhi nahi karte the nominee.
It's quite like, because that's the psychological impact it has. And it completely takes away films like Son Chiriya, which has a cultural impact. Like, there's so many films that have more than making money, they have a cultural impact on people.
Yeah.
So, and social impact. So this is really important. So I really, if there's one thing that we could change, and I'm sure nobody will disagree with that, right? Like this whole maniacal PR stunts with weekend collections, first day kitna hua, second
sab log puch rahe hain, bacche puch rahe hain, school ke bacche bhi ye baat kar rahe hain ki film ka weekend itna tha. So, humne unke andar dal diya hai baar baar wo.
And it's so strange that every weekend producers and directors meet and they discuss each other's openings.
Onward and upward to better things. But thank you for the movies, and please
thank
keep
you
creating
so
them.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Thank
so
you.
Much.
Thank you. If you like this video,
like, share, comment, subscribe
to Film Companion, or else I'll be paying you a personal visit with my ghost stories costume.